Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining us today. My goal today is to go beyond the AI hype in the tech world right now and highlight how SailPoint has consistently innovated over the years while applying AI to real-world problems. And don't worry, this is an AI talk. We're also at the front of the generative AI revolution and have a bunch of exciting features on the horizon. Let's get into our history. Back in 2017, SailPoint was the first identity security company to recognize how AI could be a force multiplier for our products. We started with a visualization of the relationships, network graphs. We then rolled into peer group analysis to identify similarities of access within organizations. The problem with the industry at that point was that there was a lot of top-down organization that didn't breathe and grow with how access was actually done in groups and organizations. We took peer group analysis and productized it for certs recommender. The first tool we built for our users focused around one of the most painful and time-consuming problems for our customers, certifications. What this did was, when certifications came up, we provided a recommendation to approve, deny, and revoke. And this was that first process where we started revoking access, highlighting the principle of least privilege. We continued to move along, and this was actually the first product I owned at SailPoint, role mining. And what peer group analysis did here was created little circles of access tightly focused on functional roles. And this was a great way to deliver value to our customers. Instead of the top-down approach, so just focused on attributes, we looked at how access was actually set up within an organization and what people used. But then as we kind of heard from our customers that role-based access control programs were expensive, clunky, and hard to maintain, we shipped Role Insights. Role Insights was a way to add entitlements over time and how access grows and applications were added. We were right there, dynamically building out better roles with the customer. And then we evolved our infrastructure and our AI offerings. We went back over our previous products and improved on them. Common access, identify outliers, contextual insights to those identity outliers. These are all improvements to those existing products. Outliers, though, was unique in that instead of providing access, we identified risk in the system. And we highlighted those people that are over-provisioned and set those off to the certifier to review. That was the way we kind of continued to embed that principle of least privilege in our AI products. Like I said, though, we're continuing to evolve our infrastructure during the whole part of this. We had built a data platform during this time, where we were starting to scale, and customers had the tools they needed, but we wanted to actually be hands-off and start actually automating some of the processes and giving this to them. So we had centralized all of our data, we had leaned into the machine learning layer of the platform, and we developed auto role mining, which actually gave those roles to customers. So instead of taking hours in the day to get into the system, those roles were right there waiting for them. We continued to evolve our infrastructure, and we're able to get access to AWS Bedrock. We're an early access customer. This allowed us to use Anthropic and Claude's foundation models, and this provided our first generative AI feature, entitlement descriptions. I'll get into that a little bit further along, but this was an important evolution of the underlying infrastructure that helped evolve our product features and top. Application onboarding is a really effective part of this, where instead of improving our product set, we knew that we had to go back and help customers with quicker time of value. Application onboarding is matching the rules and the sources and making sure you can help onboard something that's one of our toughest customer pain points. Application onboarding provides account identity maps to help admins correlate accounts for those sources. We have many more features still in the works, and we're going to only go faster and quicker and innovate more. SailPoint has found incredible value in being focused on clear customer problems and then matching the right tool to the job. Natural language search is another one of those pieces where it's a clear customer problem and ask to make search easier, and we're going to meet them there. So, you know, AI at SailPoint isn't just a buzzword. Our features lead to measurable, value-based outcomes. I did want to include this in the presentation, talking about one of our customers in the banking sector. After repeated access reviews on the same data set over several years, our clients enabled recommendations and certifications. This gave their reviewers confidence to revoke unnecessary access they would have otherwise rubber stamped. This led to 50% more entitlements revoked with recommendations enabled. Again, this is us delivering that principle of least privilege to our customers and meeting them where their biggest pain points are. And this isn't the only place where our AI-powered features are delivering value. As I mentioned, our features lead to measurable, value-based outcomes. Can't say that enough. Entitlement descriptions are important for making accurate requests, approval, and review decisions, but 64% on average of our customers' entitlement descriptions are left blank. Identifying this pain point for our customers and delivering a simple, elegant solution is our standard when shipping AI-powered features. This seemingly simple application of generative AI has been extremely well received by our customers. You heard from Ben and Jayashree that this is one of those things that came right out of the gate and people knew what they were getting. We're just getting started. We aren't slowing down and we aren't resting on our laurels, but we're accelerating innovation at SailPoint. And when you're ahead of the competition, you sometimes make valuable partnerships. At the end of 2023, AWS invited us to be a part of their Generative AI Innovation Center and is collaborating with us on a new feature. We're excited to share more about that functionality and our partnership in the near future. So, in conclusion, our journey with AI isn't just about keeping up with trends. It's about leading the way and delivering tangible value securely and at scale to our customers. And we're excited about what the future holds and how our continued innovations will drive even more success for those who trust us with their identity and security needs. It's been great. Thank you for your time today. Enjoy the rest of the presentations.